Battery is the most precious resource to Android users right now. The world is more mobile, but it's frustrating when you can't make it through the day without needing a recharge of your phone. And sadly, for most developers, battery efficiency is the last thing on their minds. My name is Colt McAnlis, and the truth is that your app doesn't have to be a battery hog. With a few simple APIs and tools, you can have a fast, awesome application that users love. But let's take a step back for a second. How bad is the state of battery usage right now? Well, Purdue University did a study of the top apps and games for mobile devices, in which they measured the battery draw of various types of actions. They made a shocking discovery. On average, only about 25 to 30% of the battery used by these applications was dedicated to the core functions of the app, like drawing images, laying out news, or throwing birds across the screen. The other 75% completely eaten up by uploading analytics, checking location, and constantly polling the server for ads to display. This finding presents an interesting problem for developers. See, these applications are effectively eating up their users' battery for their benefit, while only providing marginal features to the users, which is tricky since at the end of the day, the user's happiness is directly linked to the success of the application. Smart developers will focus on finding a balance between these two extremes by recognizing that they can perform the same actions and draw less battery at the same time. For example, waking up the device from sleep has a battery cost associated with it, so conservative use of wake locks, or rather, smarter use of wake locks, can help reduce battery drain. Likewise, some operations don't have to happen right now. For example, uploading songs, recalculating storage, or resizing your photos should probably not be done while the user is out in the middle of their holiday shopping, right? And network requests are another big drain on battery. See, each time you turn on your phone's mobile radio, it has to keep itself awake for a few seconds in case a response packet comes in, of course needing to draw extra battery just to stay awake. So if you're pulling an ad server every 5 seconds or so, you're going to be incurring the cost over and over and over again. Thankfully, Android has several tools to help you track down and fix these battery issues. Firstly, you can get battery data stats on the device by going to Settings, and then Battery, and then choosing the application you're interested in. You'll notice that the data reporting on this screen is mostly about how long your device is awake and its networking activity. And to dig deeper, you can use the Battery Historian tool to get a graphical view of how your app is using the battery over time. And once you've found your app's issues, Android has several APIs that can help you fix them. For example, using the Job Scheduler API allows your application to defer various types of work to a time when the battery is better to be used, like when it's plugged in, or when it's connected to the Wi-Fi, or the next time wakes up the device intentionally. So if you're looking to optimize your application to be lean on battery, check out the rest of the Android Performance Patterns resources to get more info on saving every last piece of this precious resource for your users. So as always, keep calm, profile your code, and remember, perf matters.